I'm basically what one would call an engineer that does art. Weathering steel and stained glass, that is my need.
Look, as you see, it's more red and orange. Do you see what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. I call it iridescent glass. When I first got to D.C., there were only artwork that was people done was at Howard University, pretty much. It wasn't too much, no other scene there. They had, D.C. was locked up for it completely. They didn't allow blacks to appear downtown. We was invisible people. That's basically what I can say, we were invisible in the art world. It never was good enough to be there, no matter what. So, it hasn't made any difference whether the federal government wanted the system or the district government, the D.C. Commission on Arts, even though they've had black executive directors, all the decision-making things in the district about art, black art especially in the city, has been made behind closed doors. And they had the blacks, they don't even allow blacks to vote on the jury. So what actually happens? Blacks don't get to tell their story. In the arts, in the outdoor arts, I'm talking about public space. I got in Southern Illinois. I saw these books. So I just started looking at them, having a good time looking at them. Then I ran into a lot of people from African countries studying there. French-speaking countries. They would come down there to learn how to speak English, basically. And so that's where I started getting in a little taste there. Well, it was a very powerful image that I saw in all this African art. The art of Africa that I've seen, it represents the people's culture. Whatever I wanted to do, they rejected it time after time after time. And I said, oh, I own this apartment building. Don't worry about that. I don't even say nothing to it. So I put it up, and my neighbors, we had a big festival that day. And I said, hey, they asked me, well, who did you ask to do this? I said, it's my property. I put it up whatever I want on it. I don't have to ask them what they want or what they think of it. See, the Anacostia Museum, from my point of view, it was designed so that blacks could have some place in the city of Washington. And the Smithsonian supported it. So they could have some place where blacks could show art, or have art shows all the time. It started about 1967 or 68. So blacks could have something over there in Anacostia, down a dead-end street. That's the most unusual. Museums are normally so people can have easy access. But somebody decided to put it down a dead-end street. It's kind of interesting to me. But it didn't matter that much. At least they have a bus go by there.
All the curators in the district have been all white. They never had a black curator or anything in the district since I've been here. And because they don't think we have anything to say or worthy of saying it, but not so.